What's up guys, this is Balázs from RacingBrick. This is the first episode of my basic tutorial series about LEGO Powered Up. Before opening the app, I would like to clarify some concepts and naming conventions, and also include a little history lesson, so let's get started. If you ever played with a motorized LEGO set in the past 10 years, then I'm sure you heard the term power functions. That was the name of LEGO's electric system introduced with the A275 motorized bulldozer set in 2007. The system had battery boxes, infrared receivers and remotes, different motors and lights, switch and extension cables. This is how the connector looks like. It is stackable, so multiple motors or lights can be connected to the same output. The motors can be operated without the remote using the switches on the battery box or with the separate switch. Some battery boxes only offered on-off state and a change of direction. The rechargeable battery box also had a speed controller. The remotes are using infrared technology, so it is usable mostly indoors, and you need a direct line of sight between the remote and the receiver. The smaller remote had bang-bang control, the train remote had speed control. The Power Functions product line has several third-party solutions. The most popular are the RacingBrick and Boovis controllers, both using Bluetooth connection and a dedicated app. They have several advanced functions. If you want to know more about them, then I suggest to take a look around on my channel. The Power Functions product line was discontinued in 2020. The components are not available anymore at lego.com. LEGO's new electric system is called Powered Up. At least I prefer to call the whole system the Powered Up product family. Unfortunately, LEGO is not very consistent with the naming, but more about this in a minute. This is how the connector looks like. As you see, it is not stackable anymore, so you are limited by the ports available on the hub. It is not compatible with the Power Functions connector, and at the moment there is no official adapter cable released by LEGO. Operation requires a smart device connected to the hub via Bluetooth. This plug and the whole architecture was used first in the V2 2.0 educational set introduced in 2016. Then the Boost Creative Toolbox was released in 2017. It was already available through retail channels, but still with an educational focus. Both of these sets had their own dedicated applications. There are different hubs, motors, and sensors included in them. The system was first called Powered Up when it was used in the app-controlled Batmobile and the passenger train sets in 2018 with the following components: a medium motor, a two-port hub that uses AAA batteries, a train motor, and a remote. A new app called Powered Up was also introduced, with dedicated control profiles for these sets. Powered Up components first appeared in a Technic set in 2019. It was the 42099 4x4 Extreme Offroader set. As a novelty, it had a 4-port hub with AA batteries and new L and XL motors. Unfortunately, they also introduced a new label on the box of the Technic sets with another app called Control Plus. Because of this, people often call these hardware elements Control Plus motors or hubs. To make it even more confusing, the internal name of the system is LPF2 or LEGO Power Functions 2. I still prefer to call it the Powered Up product family. This is also how it is categorized on lego.com. The educational line was extended with Spike Prime, introduced in 2019, with a new 6-port hub and new types of motors and sensors. In 2020, we received the new Mindstorms Robot Inventor set, which has the retail version of the Spike Prime hub and recolored motors and sensors. The core of the experience should be, and hopefully will be, the Powered Up app. Apart from having stock control profiles for the non-Technic sets like the trains, the Batmobile or the Haunted House, it has a coding canvas where the hubs and motors can be controlled with visual coding blocks. Currently, it supports these hubs and all of the available motors, but some of the sensors and the 6-port hubs are not supported. This changes with every release, but according to the developers, the aim of this app is to be the one that will provide support for all compatible hardware. If you want to know the latest status about the available components and their compatibility, then check out my page dedicated to Powered Up. You can find the link below. I'm sure some of you will ask, which system should you use? Power Functions or Powered Up? This topic deserves a video on its own, but here are a few pros and cons for both systems. Power Functions is easy to set up and use, connectors are stackable, there's a high chance that you own some components already, It does not require a smart device by default. You can use it easily for powered builds without remote control, and it has lots of compatible third-party options that extend the capabilities with advanced functions. On the other hand, it is not sold anymore by LEGO, so prices will probably get higher. The default infrared control is pretty limited. There are no or very limited interactive functions with sensors or advanced coding options. Powered Up is the recent solution, so it is available from LEGO. The system is still expanding, so we can expect new hardware coming. It has advanced interactive functions with smart motors and sensors, and there are advanced coding possibilities. About the cons, the connector is not stackable, so the builds are limited by the amount of ports on the hubs. There's no official power functions adapter, so you need to rely on third-party solutions for backward compatibility. The currently available hubs all require a smart device for control, and the app requires some coding skills if you want to use it for any custom builds. Based on this, I would say if you already have a lot of power functions components and you don't want to use sensors, interactive motors or advanced coding, then you don't necessarily need to switch to Powered Up. Power functions can still be a better choice if you want to build something motorized but not remote controlled, and you don't mind getting parts on the secondary market. If you are looking for advanced controls, interactivity, and you are not afraid of a little coding with a smart device, then Powered Up is the way to go. It is also a good choice if you only start this journey and you want something future-proof with sets and components currently available. In my next videos, I will focus on the Powered Up app and I will show you step-by-step the abilities and how its full potential can be used with the hardware components. I hope you find this video useful. Stay tuned and check the description as it will be updated with links to the following episodes. See you next time, bye bye!